360, Nitro.tv. Tu ne veux pas manquer ça.
Calgary. They had 24 points at RPM on Monday night as part of a Quebec Bowl.
Thank you.
VIP and Ryan is doing his undertaking tab for the race.
Getting out of the car, he can hear you. The 17 of Yannick Poitevin. Yannick, félicitations. Je veux dire, finalement, je pense qu'on est rendu 1er juillet. Habituellement, l'année passée, tu avais gagné avant ça. La compétition est très forte. Je pense que tu as eu beaucoup de malchance depuis le début de la saison. Semblait avoir peut-être des problèmes d'embrayage où on jouait un petit peu chat et souris lors des relances.
Ouais, on jouait pas mal à chat et souris. Je sais que Justin, il est pas mal vite. Puis il essayait tout le temps d'amener son nez en avant de moi pour décoller. J'ai joué un peu avec ça, là. Puis ça a bien allé. Ah, cette année, on a bien de la misère avec la voiture. Il y a tout le temps quelque chose qui arrive, mais là, je suis bien content pour la victoire ce soir. Puis je le mérite bien.
La compétition, comme on mentionnait, est extrêmement forte. Tu as mentionné Justin Jourdouin, Alexis Charbonneau. Les gars, vous avez joué quand même ce soir, encore une fois, très propre. La piste très glissante également. C'est des conditions qu'on n'a pas été habitué de voir au cours de la saison. Ça fait deux semaines qu'elle est extrêmement glissante. Comment est-ce que tu aimes mieux ces conditions-là ou des conditions plus mouillées, mettons?
Ah, t'as bien vu l'année passée, toutes les victoires que j'ai eues, c'est sur une traque collante, mais on va falloir s'habituer, on est ici pour apprendre puis essayer d'aller en avant de toutes les sortes de la piste à l'eau.
Donc, félicitations pour ta victoire, on va t'en souhaiter d'autres cette saison.
Merci.
So, Yannick Poitevin, your mini stock feature winner here tonight. So just to translate a little bit, he's really fortunate to he's really happy to have won his first of the season. A lot of bad luck for him. I've asked him if he was having some issues with the car on the restarts. He said no, I was playing cat and mouse with the other car because he knows that Justin Jourdouin is always strong. So Yannick Poitevin really happy to be able to win here tonight.
Thank you.
into turn number three. Hands up, one down. It's time to put the power to the ground. Thank you.
this year, Super Matt Shepard. The cool part is you get a bottle of vodka for winning tonight too, Matt. Oh man, third straight year you've graced Victory Lane here at this place. You really know this place well. Take us through your night. It seemed pretty wild with all the lap traffic.
Yeah, I mean, man, was this place slick tonight. We were up there on the ragged edge, you know, just trying to find every ounce of grip we could find. You know, I had a heck of a battle there with Danny for a long, long time, and I think we were throwing some sparks there down the front stretch. Man, that was a tough track, really, really tough track tonight. It's a track you got to be really patient on, a lot more patient than you want to. Little different than we're used to seeing. We're used to seeing this place a little heavier, but just really happy to be here. I got to thank my good buddy, the Grinder. He's been running here every week, and we kind of threw his setup in there for the feature because we didn't really know what to do. And, you know, if it wasn't for the stuff he did in the Concy there, we probably wouldn't be sitting here in Victory Lane tonight.
Wow, that's, you know, that's interesting. Of course, this racetrack, as you mentioned, very, very tough. That outside lane, you and Danny Johnson had quite the battle going for the lead. Beth said that your pay is going to be docked because there's a little scratch in the back bumper, but you'll take it either way, right? You had a great battle going on all night with him.
Yeah, you know, he was very good. He was running just a touch lower than I wanted to run, and I kept getting a big run on him on the top, and, you know, he kept closing the door, so I tried to show him a nose there on the bottom for a little while, try and bait him down the track, and finally got a big run. I think I caught him by surprise a little bit, and, you know, the sparks were flying, but we got out front, and, you know, from there, the big battle was just keeping it on the racetrack and, you know, trying to be patiently aggressive with the lap cars.
Now, Plattsburgh tomorrow night, you were in the thick of the battle right there at the end with Danny. What are your thoughts going into another half, the big half mile at Plattsburgh tomorrow night?
Oh, looking forward to it. You know, it's such a beautiful facility, much like this place. And, you know, anytime we can get up here, you know, just north of the border in northern New York, a lot of great fans up here. And hopefully, you know, they get another great show tomorrow night.
19th win of the season, Matt. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Matt Shepard is a winner once again. Hi, Larry. Welcome back. How's it going? Great run there tonight. Your car was, I think it was just as good as Matt's. I don't know what your thoughts on tonight were.
Yeah, an open track, he seemed to be a little bit better rolling that top and middle. I'm not sure if we were just a little too free or what the deal was, but he could definitely get a little bit better drive off. But I think once we got into the lap traffic there, we were a little bit better on the bottom, and we rolled them in on that, and I don't know if we, maybe if we had about 5-10 more laps and could get a little bit closer to him, we might have made something happen if he tried to slide a lap car or something. But we were right in the hunt. I think we just got to work on it a little bit.
Anybody want to thank tonight, bud?
I thank my mom, my dad, everything they do. My wife, Brooke, my daughter, Audrey, they're watching on TV right now. Can't do it without their support. Everybody in the pits, you know, Brandon, Jake, Scott Jeffrey. You know, without those guys, Bulldog, there's no way we could all do this. And Bicknell Racing Products, LJL Kevlar Engines, Penske Shocks, FX Carrera Chevrolet, Gypsum Express, the whole Gypsum Group, Big Red Towing, State International, Napa Auto Parts, and Tracy Road Equipment.
Well, we'll see you tomorrow night in Plattsburgh. Maybe take another trophy home.
We're going to try to.
All right, Larry White comes home. Matt Williamson, I think I've talked to you every night this week. Wednesday night, Can-Am, Thursday, big win at Fulton. Top three here tonight. You had a decent race car. Did you think you had anything for those other two up front?
I don't think so. Matt had a good car. Larry was, you know, pretty good too. We faded early there, and that long run killed us. I think we just got the rear tire too hot, and fortunately a couple yellows, and, you know, things went our way, and we were good on the restarts again tonight, and got back up into the top three.
Anybody want to thank here tonight, man?
Yeah, this is our own car, so I got to thank, you know, everybody that helps out on this. We left this morning, and you know, little Johnny stayed back and washed the small block from last night, so I got to thank him. S&W Service Center, Optional Hose and Hydraulics, Jason Enterprises, Behrens, Bicknell's, Daryl Johnson Incorporated, iBox Springs, Integra Shocks, VP Race and Fuel, everybody that just makes it happen.
You're driven so many race cars this week. You got every sponsor in all the nights you've run. Congratulations, buddy, and happy Canada Day. Go have another beer.
Thank you.
All right, sounds good. Matt Williamson comes home third.
He can hear you, the one of Robert Delormier, your sportsman feature winner here tonight. A souvenir, wax wing gin for you, sponsored by Artist Industry. You'll be able to drink that with your team. Robert, what a ride to hear tonight. The streak is over for Shane Picor. The guy seemed to be unbeatable, but you were able to bring the 1X in the winner circle here tonight. What a run. The track was in pristine conditions. I know a little bit of rain. We almost had to come back for later on, but you're here in the winner circle.
Yeah, you know what? We raced here the first race, and we kind of have a little mishap there, and then we skipped all the races until now, and we watched Shane win all them races, and it was hard just to let the car sit at home and not compete with the guy. And we came here just to see if we could beat Shane tonight, and I guess we did it.
Will we see you again this season with you being in the winner's circle? I'm pretty sure we'll see your car here at a few more occasions by the end of this year.
Yeah, we'll definitely be here for the Race for the Cure series races, and maybe a few others after. And the track has come together well after the first few races there, and nice slick track, because that's what we want.
Anyone you would like to thank on your team tonight? I know it seems to be a really strong hot rod.
Yeah, I got to thank Dave Thompson for the great car, and all his crew. All the guys put effort into it all week long, and long hours. And I got to thank DTC Trucking, Express Gas, Dale and Brandon at Dig Race Products, their shocks. And yeah, all the fans for sticking around. Looked like it was going to rain earlier. Thank you.
So congratulations on your win, and hopefully we'll see you again here in Cornwall this season. A good round of applause for Robert Delormier, your sportsman winner here tonight.